The SpaceX insane new Raptor engines. Do you believe in the power of science? Better yet, do you think an engine that can be reused over 1,000 times can be made? Well, if you don't, then you need to hear about the new SpaceX Raptor engine. To get humans to Mars, SpaceX is building the mighty Starship spacecraft, powered by the Raptor engine. One of the first to be powered by methane and designed to be reused 1,000 times. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has his mindset on going to Mars. To do so will require a vast new spacecraft, powered by a new rocket engine, unlike anything that's been seen before. Step forward, Raptor, the future of SpaceX's endeavors. In this video, we look at the insane engineering behind the SpaceX Raptor engines. But before we begin, if you haven't yet subscribed to our channel, kindly do so by clicking on the subscribe icon below. Also, give us a like, share the video, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for timely updates of our weekly uploads. Let's get it on! A feat of engineering on its own, the Raptor recently set a rocketry record by achieving the highest combustion chamber pressure ever of 330 bar, which produces over 500,000 pounds of force. The Raptor is also the only engine in existence to use the full-flow staged combustion cycle for power, a historically complex process to implement. The Raptor is designed to power the new, reusable vehicles SpaceX is building. The Starship spacecraft and the Super Heavy rocket. Combined, these vast machines are designed to take up to 100 people into space, possibly to the Moon and Mars, with a tentative launch of humans around the Moon planned in 2023. SpaceX tested the first flight-ready version of Raptor in February 2019. It flew a Raptor for the first time on a hop test of a prototype of Starship called Star Hopper. The engine has been in development for the better part of a decade, going through a number of iterations. At its core, it's like other engines, burning chemical fuel to produce thrust. But its use of liquid oxygen and methane, something largely unprecedented in the rocket industry, and its innovative design means that it might be SpaceX's ace in the hole when it comes to exploring the solar system. There is no other rocket engine capable of producing as much energy out of liquid methane and liquid oxygen as the Raptor engines, says Tim Dodd, an industry expert who runs the popular Everyday Astronaut YouTube channel, and making it more reusable with little to no refurbishment is the idea. That's definitely going to help their business case if they can just fly over and over. The reusability is the key aspect. As Musk has said, each engine needs to be capable of flying up to 1,000 times to support the ambitious operations of Starship. That's a major challenge. The most reused engines in space exploration history were the main engines on each space shuttle, which flew up to only a few dozen times each. It's quite ambitious, says Dodd. I don't know if 1,000 flights are necessarily going to be achievable in the near future. If it lives up to its potential, maybe 1,000 is within the reach of possibility one day. In 2018, standing in front of a shiny full-scale prototype of SpaceX's Starship vehicle in South Texas, Elon Musk said he wants the company's gigantic next-generation rocket to fly into orbit within 6 months, a bold schedule that he acknowledged requires exponential improvements in design and manufacturing. Regardless of when the futuristic-looking vehicle reaches orbit for the first time, Musk told several hundred employees, local supporters, space enthusiasts, and space reporters, along with thousands more watching online, that SpaceX will build a fleet of Starships and launch them from sites in Texas and Florida. The first full-size prototype of SpaceX's Starship space vehicle, named Starship MK-1, and built last summer on the South Texas coast, should be ready to launch on a high-altitude atmospheric test flight in 2021, Musk said. The Raptor engine is powered by subcooled liquid methane and subcooled liquid oxygen in a full-flow staged combustion cycle, a departure from the simpler open-cycle gas generator system and kerosene propellants that many engines use. The Raptor engine is designed for the use of deep cryogenic propellants, fluid-cooled to near their freezing points, which is typical for cryogenic rocket engines. This is the true power of the Raptors. When you take all the engineering hurdles the designers overcame, all the optimizations implemented, and all the decisions made, you end up with the most cost-efficient rocket engine in history. It is intended for Starship to make 6 Raptors mounted on it, 3 for sea-level use and 3 for vacuum use, while 28 are to be mounted on the Super Heavy booster, which may carry Starship into space. SpaceX assembled the first Starship prototypes in the open, in public view, not inside a climate-controlled factory with strict cleanliness requirements. Musk said it would have taken too long to construct a dedicated assembly building for the Starship. And instead of building the vehicles out of carbon fiber, As many modern rockets use, the Starship is made of stainless steel. The structures of modern launch vehicles are primarily made of carbon fiber or aluminium. But rockets designed in an earlier era, such as the Atlas Centaur, conceived in the 1950s and the 1960s, flew with a stainless steel skin. Up until October of last year, we were pursuing a completely different design, Musk said, referring to SpaceX's switch to a stainless steel structure for the Starship, reversing earlier plans to construct it out of carbon fiber. The Raptor is the most powerful engine ever built by SpaceX. The earlier version of the Raptor engine can produce up to 440,000 pounds of thrust at sea level, roughly equivalent to the main engine flown on the space shuttle. Musk has often spoken about his dream of building cities on Mars. He believes the settlements would need large numbers of people in order to become self-sustaining. Realizing this dream requires a vehicle that's up to the task. Starship is a rocket and spacecraft combination that could ferry more than 100 people at a time to the Red Planet. And it will change the dynamics of space travel. How, one may ask? The system is designed to be fully reusable, meaning the principal hardware elements are not discarded in the sea or allowed to burn up, as happens with some other launch systems. These are instead recovered from space. They can then be refurbished and flown again, reducing the cost of the whole enterprise. The Raptor engine's development from 2009 to 2015 was funded exclusively through private investment by SpaceX, with no government funding. In January 2016, SpaceX did agree with the US Air Force to take $33.6 million in Defense Department funding in order to develop a particular Raptor model, a prototype of a new upper stage variant of the Raptor engine designed for potential use as an upper stage on Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy, with SpaceX agreeing to fund at least $67.3 million on the upper stage development project on a minimum 2:1 ratio, private to government funding basis. Previously, SpaceX had wanted to ignite Super Heavy's Raptor engines to guide it down to a precision landing on 6 steel legs. SpaceX does something similar with the first stage of its Falcon 9 rockets, landing them safely on landing pads and drone ships after a launch. But Mr. Musk recently tweeted to say that this thinking has changed. SpaceX now plans to catch the falling booster using an arm on the launch tower. This is the structure that provides engineers and crew members with access to the spacecraft and the rocket while they are sitting on the pad before launch. Now, how exactly this catch mechanism is going to work, however, remains to be seen. Nevertheless, Elon Musk has promised a lunar excursion in 2023 to the Japanese online retail billionaire Yusaku Maezawa. Mr. Maezawa will fly around the moon in a Starship with 8 other individuals. Musk has also said he will aim to launch one of the vehicles on an uncrewed flight to Mars in 2024. Even if the SpaceX founder's timeline might seem optimistic at times, he has also developed a reputation for eventually achieving his goals, no matter how ambitious. Let's wait and see how this one goes. There we go. Did you enjoy our video? Ultimately, do you think the Raptor engines will be 100% effective and can be reused and redesigned? Well, if you enjoyed our video, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more of our amazing and informative content. Please give us a like, share the video, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell for timely updates of our latest uploads. We value your feedback. Please feel free to share your thoughts with us in the comment section below.